Welcome to video 18 on Flight Sim Navigation. The previous two videos were about this Android app called FS Radio Panel, and I like flying with it so much that the idea came to mind to create a real hardware panel, sort of a cockpit. And this is the first video of the takeoff of this project. This FS radio panel, well, it has these nice knobs over here, but they are sort of virtual knobs. So in my mind I had this idea to why not create a cockpit panel. I imagine a wooden panel with real hardware knobs on that are rotational encoders, and with which we can tune these frequencies. So what needs to be done is to figure out how to do that, and I googled some for the link between Arduino, and those are small mini computers. For $3 you can already have one. And FSX, so Arduino and FSX, that's combination. And there came up two applications that could connect the flight sim with an Arduino, and one of them is this Mobi Flight. It's really interesting software. You don't have to program anything on the Arduino yourself, you only need to configure it. So I had a couple of hardware encoders still lying around. I also happened to have a Arduino Pro Mini, which is needed. It's not a standard Arduino, you can only use a Arduino with a special USB interface. And the Mega is okay, which has a lot of I/O, and the Pro Mini is okay too. And then of course you have this Mobi Flight app. We are not going to do this in depth in this video. In a future video we'll have a look how to configure it, but that is what you need to do. The hardware is configured, so over here I have my two encoders and each of them has also a switch. So this hardware is configured, so to speak, and then you configure the software, which is telling the program what it needs to do when encoder one is rotated. It's going to influence the heading bug, and if encoder two is rotated, in this case I configured it to tune my NAV1 radio megahertz, and if I press the switch it toggles to kilohertz. Well, let's have a look. This is the panel that I now intend to build. It is a complete radio panel with these knobs over here controlling these radios, and then we also have a complete autopilot, and that is of course more interesting with this screen. Here we have a Cessna autopilot, and all these knobs over here, altitude, vertical speed, heading, they are operational, and all these push buttons also, they have an internal LED, so if they are green they are on. And of course the other panels, this is a larger airplane flight display, and there's the larger autopilot. It's all going to work together. So having this FS radio panel app with all its different screens, the moving map is also still there, and the switch panel is over there, so we can actually we have a complete cockpit with not too much work. You can of course, I've seen those videos of guys that build incredible, beautiful, wonderful home cockpits, but they already are a couple of thousands of dollars mostly because of the expensive modules. Even if we would get these three SciTech modules, which are very nice, they already set us back €300. And this is the goal, build this cockpit. I agree, it doesn't look like any real plane cockpit, but I don't mind about that. The fun is, it's only $40, which includes the FS radio panel software. It includes an Arduino Mega, a couple of encoders and a couple of switches and a couple of displays. That's it. And of course, the fun of building it. So let's have a quick look at the first feasibility test using the two encoders.
Alright, first test. Over here we have FSX running. We have two hardware encoders connected to an Arduino Pro Mini. And those are controlled here by the MobiFlight app. More on how to configure that in a later video. And we have the FS radio panel app also running. Maybe I best zoom in a little bit here on the heading bug so we can do a first test. If I, oh, that is not going quite easy, a bit sensitive. Yeah, the if I would rotate the heading bug over here, then we can see that also over there on the radio panel it is connected. And now for the real test, it is also configured to be one of these digital encoders, and well, that works perfectly fine as we can see. So that is a very nice first test, promising to do the rest of the project. And also the radio panel over here, this second encoder is connected to this NAV1 over here, and if I would be able to zoom in on the radio over here, 11300 11300, and look what happens if I rotate it, it all goes in sync. And more, if I press it, then I can tune the megahertz, and we can see the numbers changing over here and also over there. Well, this first test is really promising. I like FS radio panel, I like MobiFlight, and I'm going to build this radio stack plus autopilot panel. The next video will probably be about how to configure MobiFlight to listen to these encoders, and more than that, how you can get it done that when you press it, that you change from kilohertz to megahertz. That is a little trick, but not really difficult. Maybe see you back there. Bye bye.